Are you ready?
Yeah, we'll start with the most important question. My hair. Yeah, I do. I play a lot with my hair, my clothes. I've always been like that since I can remember. I used to get my mother and my father very unhappy because I want to do this with my hair. I want these clothes. So I've always been like that. And being a woman, I think I use that privilege to extend my femininity in any way I choose. And so... Yeah, I hope it's more an evolution. I mean, taking the hair away from the music. You know, my hair, I just think, how do I want to do my lipstick today? The hair is just an extension of that. But musically, I think who I choose to work with and in terms of producers, musicians, I change. But I think it's just about shedding skin and perhaps revealing yourself of who, more of who you are, rather than changing. It's about, for me, revealing more of myself. Well, it was, you know, I felt the culture shock, I think, perhaps in my 20s. But as a child, I was 13, 14, you know, it's very exciting, new things, a new environment. It was like arriving at a fairground. And we had lived in a totalitarian government, which means a lot of censorship in terms of creativity. So we were only given what we were allowed to be shown, really. And so coming to England and discovering this whole world of jazz, although I rather look at it as black classical music, was an absolute revelation for me, in particular Billie Holiday and Ella Fitzgerald, about... with the content of what they were singing and the way they were singing it and how there were these incredibly strong, powerful women which showed their vulnerability, which to me is a strength, and also educated me through the songs that they sang and the lyrics and their history. So I fell into this kind of obsession, if you like. I listened to them endlessly. I was voraciously eating this kind of... music up for, yeah, through my teenage years. As well as I used to go, you know, also listening for others, clubs or little things with my friends. We'd listen to, you know, like club music. And I was also into a lot of Motown, but primarily I was into this kind of black classical music.
My baby don't care for shows. My baby don't care for clothes. My baby just cares for me. My baby don't care for cars. My baby don't care for high-toned places. Scarlett Johansson is not his style, or even the beautiful Rihanna's smile is something he can see. What is wrong with my baby? My baby just cares for me.
To me, it's just music, you know, it's all music. And that's what I love about being a musician, because we all are able to share this voice. And it's just about speaking about your inner being and wanting to share something wonderful and something that is so intrinsic to human nature. So for me, it's music is religion, it's faith, it's hope, it's beautiful, it's pain, it's degradation. It's all there in the lyrics, in the music. So it's all about life, and I don't disassociate myself as those are two different things. For me, it's all in the same. After being in the world of music I'd been making with Andre Manukian, had a different producer, and then I did Black Orchid, the homage to Nina Simone, I just wanted to work with someone different, and perhaps a different medium to work with. And from my bass, upright bass, piano and drums, so I wanted to do the kind of something electro. And Boris was around through a contact of a friend of a friend, and then I approached him, and he was gracious enough to concede that we work on a project together. So I think this also encourages me to develop in a different way. But I think it's just, like I said, it's about developing more of myself, something that's already there, and that music brings it out. So I found his music really, for me, the first time I think I stepped into one of his sound carpets, I really felt like I was in a three-dimensional sound, walking into a space, into a desert, into a landscape. I was walking into a painting, and that was really... I think that's an absolute truth. I mean, this album was born out of my diagnosis with breast cancer. And perhaps even having that diagnosis propelled me to contact Boris. I said, I'm just going to try, you know, what have I got to lose? So a lot of the lyrics are born out of, I was going through the diagnosis of going through treatment. So from the beginning of the album, I was really literally down with the chemotherapies, with all the drugs I had to take. So I was in a very low place, but at the same time, a very powerful place, because you understand life in a very different perspective. You know, you understand how wonderful and deep and beautiful that life is. And I think when you sing or write lyrics, this is going to reflect in that. And then by the end of the album, when we finished making songs like I Feel It Like You, I had a bigger smile on my face, and I was a little bit more leisure and enjoying life. So it's, the album really starts from the beginning to the end of my treatments, if you like, and being able to stand without my back bent by the end of the album making, and saying, okay, I'm now resuming myself. And music always kept me going. I always had time. I felt strong to go into the studio, even though sometimes I might be weak, but I could still always go and sing a song. Yeah, I think I have lots and lots of memories, and a lot of them stem behind the band that I work around with and the good times that we have with them. Of course, working with the different producers, but for me, when I'm making music and having ideas in my head and then realizing it in a song and recorded or playing it live. I have a lot of those moments. I really do. Yeah, planes do that to me. Seeing the whole horizon and the clouds and the universe kind of brings that kind of peace and silence where words can come out. And usually for me, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, start writing something, or a conversation I have with somebody that touches me, that might instigate something, a film or a book that I might read that instigates something. But I do write a lot on trains, planes, and in the early hours of the morning when I've had an argument with my husband.
It's been 9 years and 16 days of hope. It's been hard times, good times coming home. But still we laugh hard, we play hard till dawn. This love, an oak tree, grows on and on. Bring that heat back to my bones. Your footsteps are mine. Your love's so divine. Your heart warms me when I'm cold. And out of my dreams, you came along. I waited so
There's a kind of a color that's in between green and blue, not quite turquoise, not quite jade, something in there. The color of the ocean, I think, a really clear ocean color. Some in a Pacific island, I love this color. Oh, absolutely, the sound of my daughter's voice. And she sings Fever very well. It's something I'm still working on. It's an evolution for me because I'm a very hyper person. I don't switch off very easily. So I do tend to abstain quite a bit. But it's important, I think, more than I realize. I have moments, you know. I think it's a difficult question. I mean, I don't switch music off in a way, my work, but I also I enjoy my life. I enjoy my family, I enjoy my daughter, I enjoy walking. Those things are also really important to me. So I think when I have to work and I know I have to put my heart and soul into something, then I'm there. But I also can switch off and really dive into my family life, which is really, really, really important to me.
Manda, get up, manda. Kusale matope, manda gerok manda gerok manda. Yeah, manda gerok manda gerok manda.